In this video, I'm going to show you how you can set up data quality rules in your ETL pipeline to improve your data. Why is this important? Well, data is growing exponentially and business needs reliable data at a faster pace in order to be agile. At the same time, quality of data is critical for efficient business operation. Otherwise, a lot of time is wasted in fixing the data and data consumers lose trust in the data. Let's preview the data using the Data Preview tab. This data contains sales information such as customer ID, product ID of product purchase, quantity of purchase, and total sales. To create data quality rules, let's add Evaluate Data Quality Transform. It comes with helper that lets you explore available rules that can be applied and the schema where rules can be applied. This will create data quality rules in Data Quality Definition Language or DQDL. Let's make sure this dataset has at least 1,000 records. To do this, I'm going to add row count rule and check for value greater than 1,000. To check whether total underscore sales column is greater than 0, I will add column values rule. This will make sure total underscore sales column is always positive. For complex data quality rules, I'll create custom SQL rule. Here, I'm checking for records where quantity equals to 0 and the values of total underscore sales column is greater than 0. In case we want to check the referential integrity for the sales dataset, similar to how you would do for a relational database where two tables are linked using a primary key and a foreign key, I can choose referential integrity rule. Let's search for the referential integrity rule and add it to the data quality rule. I have added products as the second data source containing product underscore key as the primary key. I'll add products as the node parent and let's use reference as the table alias. Sales dataset has product underscore ID, which is a foreign key. I'll add a rule to check that all the values of product underscore ID column are present in the products dataset. After creating the data quality rule, choose original data under data quality transform output. I'll also enable add new columns to indicate data quality errors. Let's review the data preview tab, where you can see that the data quality results for each record is appended as columns to the original data. You can choose to send the output of data quality results to Amazon CloudWatch. This can be done under Data Quality Actions section by choosing option Publish Results to Amazon CloudWatch. On Rule Set Failure, you can choose to continue or fail job based on specific criteria. Additionally, I can publish data quality events to Amazon EventBridge. Glue ETL job script can be deployed via CI/CD pipeline. As a best practice, you should version control and use CI/CD pipeline to deploy Glue ETL job scripts. Following is my Glue ETL job, and using DQDL syntax, I will create or modify data quality rules within the Glue ETL job scripts. In order to segregate good records from the bad, I have created conditional router transform. I have added conditions to the data quality evaluation results column, which will match to the value passed in order to segregate these records. I'll now use S3 target transform to store records matching the value passed and failed to specific S3 prefix location. Next, I will run my Glue ETL job that will execute the Glue data quality script that was created. After the job completion, you can visit the data quality tab to see the data quality results. You can see that the data quality score is 50%. This is because 2 out of the 4 rules have failed. You have all the failed record details in S3 location. So let us go to the S3 location to view the failed records using S3 select. I can fetch some sample failed records. Here, I can find the root cause of the data quality issues and follow up with the data producer team to remediate it. Applications use machine learning to make data-driven decisions. However, the success is heavily dependent on the quality of data. At the base of data, we need data quality checks in the ETL pipeline so quality data is available immediately. In this video, you have seen how you can create Glue data quality jobs and add this to your ETL pipeline to identify missing, stale, or bad data before it impacts your business. Backed by trustworthy data, your business can now make confident data-driven decisions. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, give it a like. See you next time.